Good morning, everyone. So we have already started your subject, that is wind energy. And in the last lecture, we have already seen this topic, that is wind generation, in which we cover the part that is history of windmills. Okay. So I just revise these things, that solar energy, wind energy is a byproduct of the solar energy, because the 2% of solar energy is utilized to heat the earth's surface, and this uneven heating of the surface converted into the wind energy. Okay, so whatever the history that I have already discussed in the last lecture, so those who are absent in the last lecture can go through the video that I have already provided on your group. Okay, this part is also covered, that is what is a wind turbine power plant or windmill. This diagram shows the horizontal wind turbine. So in the last lecture we have seen there are two different types of windmill. One is your horizontal axis wind turbine. This is the diagram of horizontal axis wind turbine and the vertical axis wind turbine. See, this is the diagram of vertical axis wind turbine. And we have already discussed the difference between horizontal axis and vertical axis, in which horizontal axis wind turbine having higher efficiency than that of the vertical axis. That's why they are commercially used in engineering applications for the production of power. Okay. Now, we come to this point, that is what are the main components of windmill. See, this part I have also explained shortly in the last lecture. Today we are going to discuss this part in detail, because one question should be asked on this topic. Okay, let's see what are the different components of windmills. So in this figure you can see there is a nacelle. This portion is called as the nacelle. This complete portion is called nacelle, in which the first part is your hub on which the blades are mounted. Okay, then this hub is connected to the main shaft. This is a low speed shaft. Okay, then this low speed shaft is connected to the gearbox transmission, and the output shaft coming from this gearbox transmission is connected to the brake, and that shaft is connected to the generator. Okay, and whatever power produced inside the generator is supplied with the help of this wire to the battery supply or high tension supply. Okay, so this is complete is your housing. Okay, let's see each part. I have already covered this portion, that is what is rotor. Rotor is the portion of wind turbine that collects energy from the wind, called rotor. The rotor usually consists of two or more wooden, fiberglass or metal blades which rotate about an axis, that is about horizontal axis or vertical axis. About horizontal axis in case of horizontal wind turbine, and about vertical axis in case of vertical turbine. Okay, then the blades are attached to the hub, which is turn is attached to the main shaft. As shown in the figure, the blades are attached to the hub, and that hub should connect it to the main shaft. Then drag design. The blade design operate on either the principle of drag or lift. Okay, so this part is also I have explained what is meant by drag, what is meant by lift. So drag is basically the resistance to the movement of air, and lift is helps to move a particular object, or it helps for the movement of the object. Okay, so drag power wind turbines are characteristic by slower rotational speed and having higher torque capabilities. Okay, then lift design. In case of lift design, the lift bed design employs the same principle that enables airplane, kites, and birds to fly. Means the design, the aerodynamic shape of design, which minimize the drag, which minimize the resistance of air, and maximize the speed of that object. So such a design is called as lifted design or aerodynamic design. Okay. The blade is essentially an aerofoil or wing shape. The blade are designed like wing shape or aerofoil shape in order to increase the velocity of that particular wind. Okay. So in lift design, when air flows past the blade, a wind speed and the pressure differential is created between the upper and lower blade surface. So here, due to aerofoil shape or wing shape, there is a pressure and wind speed difference is created in between that upper and lower blade surface. Okay, in between that upper and lower blade surface, upper and lower blade surface. So that aerofoil shape helps to increase the velocity. The pressure at the lower surface is greater and thus act to lift the blade. Suppose the blade continuously rotating. If the pressure is lower, pressure at lower surface is greater, then that pressure helps to again revolve the blade in circular manner. Okay, like your, in case of your flywheel is having high weight at the bottom, and while production of energy inside the engine, that in power stroke it save or store the energy, and that energy utilized in the compression and exhaust stroke in case of your flywheel. Similarly, the higher pressure of the lower side blade helps to lift the blade up. Okay, so when blades are attached to the central axis, like a wind turbine rotor, a lift is translated into rotational motion. Okay, so that central axis try to rotate that particular blade in rotational motion. Okay, lift powered wind turbines have much higher rotational speed than drag types of wind turbine, because in lift power they are continuously rotated, and due to higher pressure at bottom, that helps to rotate it continuously with higher rotational speed as compared with the drag type design. Okay, and therefore well suited for the electricity generation. That's why for the electricity generation, those windmills we have used for the electricity generation, we are using lift type of wind turbine. Okay, so one question should be come in your mind. So what are the different uses of windmill? We are not using windmill just for the purpose of electricity generation, but also for the different applications like water pumping. So in case of water pumping, we doesn't require the regularities of rotational motion. We require just a power taking capacity. So in that case, we should use track type design. Okay, but for uniformity of rotation of that blade is necessary for electricity generation. That's why we use the lift type design in electricity generation windmills. Okay, see, this is the aerofoil blade section. This section is called as aerofoil shape. This section is called as aerofoil shape. When wind is strike at the blade point, this lift helps to rotate that blades, because the pressure is higher at the bottom and lower at top. So that's why this lift will help to rotate that blade. So this is your aerofoil shape. Okay, so this is your aerofoil shape, or we can say aerodynamic shape, which minimize the drag and maximize the lift. Following figure gives an idea about the drag and lift principle. Okay, so this is a wind, and these are the counter lines of wind when they strike this aerofoil shape. This concept you have already learned in your fluid mechanics, what is counter mechanism or what is contour lines. Whenever any fluid strike at solid surface, they move their path lines, strip lines, stream lines, that concept, they move their path according to the shape. Those who are currently learning your last year, in second year, I have taken this practical of in the fluid mechanics, that how the path of fluid is produced in aerofoil shape. Okay. See, next is your tip speed ratio. The tip speed is the ratio of rotational speed of the blade to the wind speed. The rotational speed of blade to the wind speed, that ratio is called as the tip speed ratio. Means this ratio indicates that how much power is going to produce with the help of that wind available. Okay. So it is a ratio of rotational speed to the wind speed. Okay. And this ratio should be maximum larger when your design of your blades, rotor blade should be aerodynamic or aerofoil shape. Okay. Electricity generation require higher rotational speed. This is a important factor, as I already told you. For electricity generation, high rotational speed and uniform rotational speed is required. Okay, lift type wind turbines having maximum tip speed ratios of around 10, while track type ratios are approximately 1. Means what is tip speed ratio? It is a ratio of rotational speed of the blade to the wind speed. So as much as the tip speed ratio is high, the efficiency of your power generation is high. So that's why in case of lift type wind turbine, it is nearly about 10. And in case of truck type, it is nearly 1. So that's why we use lift type wind turbines. Okay. Next, given the high rotational speed requirement of the electric generators, it is clear that the lift type wind turbine is most practical for the application. So it is most practical for the application. The number of blades that make up a rotor and the total area they cover affect the wind turbine performance. Okay. The number of blades that make up a rotor and the total area they cover affect the wind turbine performance. Means wind turbine performance also depends upon the number of blades used and total area they swept during the rotation. Okay. So according to wind turbine performance, we should choose the proper length and dimension of the wind turbine rotor blades. Okay. So in your third unit, wind turbine power production and torque, we see the numericals on this selection of size and dimension of the particular blade rotor blades. For the lift type rotor to function effectively, the wing must flow smoothly over the blades. Okay, so drag should be minimum and we get higher lift. So our tip speed ratio should be as high as possible. So that's why in order to function effectively, the wing must flow smoothly over the blades. Means drag should be minimum. To avoid the turbulence, spacing between the blades should be great enough so that one blade will not encounter the disturbed weaker airflow caused by the blade which passes before it. Means the difference between this blade should be enough as possible so that they cannot disturb the airflow for the next rotation of your blade. Okay. It is because of this requirement that most wind turbines have only two or three blades on their rotor. So because of this requirement, we are using only two blade rotor system or maximum three blade rotor systems. We are not going to use large number of blades. So So what is the reason behind that? To avoid the turbulence of air during movement of that particular blade. See, now what is the function of generator? Generator is what? The generator converts the turning motion of wind turbine blade into electricity. Whatever wind, whatever energy is produced by the rotational speed of that particular blade, that rotational speed is going to be utilized to generate the power, and this rotational shaft speed is going to be converted into electricity by using generator. Okay, inside this component, coil of wire are rotated in the magnetic field to produce the electricity. We all know the law of EMF generation, that is, whenever a current carrying conductor is placed inside the electromagnetic field, it produces the EMF or electricity. Means that rotational field, in that rotational field where we place a current coil conductor, that conductor produces the electricity. So on the basis of this law, that generator works. The different generator design produce either alternating current or direct current, and they are available in large number of output power rating. So here some generators produces the AC current or some produces the DC current. So as per our requirement, we can again convert that AC into DC or DC into AC. That is the lateral part, but it is depend upon, according to your requirement, you can set the generator as per your requirement. Okay. The generator rating or size is dependent on the length of wind turbine blade, because more energy is captured by the longer blade. So generator capacity is basically dependent upon the size of your rotor blade. Okay. It is important to select the right type of generator to match intent use. Means according to size, we have to choose the right type of generator. Okay. Most home and office appliances operate on 240 volts and 50 cycle AC. So this is our operating volt and current situation. What is the current and volt requirement at office and appliances? So that is 240 volt and 50 cycle AC. Some appliances can be operate on either AC or DC, such as light bulbs and resistance heater, and many others can be adapted to run on DC. So according to that, we have to select the generator. See, storage system using batteries store DC and usually are configured at voltage of between 12 volt to 120 volts. Okay, if we are using the battery for the storage, then that battery should store the energy or electricity in the form of DC form, and whenever we require, we can convert by using alternator. That DC should be converted into AC for the home appliances. Okay. Generators that produce AC are generally equipped with features to produce a correct voltage of 240 volt and constant frequency 50 cycles of electricity. Even the wind speed is fluctuating. Means what? If we are using the wind electricity plant or wind turbine plow for your office or home purposes, then we have this 240 volt voltage and 50 cycle of electricity. So in that case, we are going to use the AC generator. They are featured with correct voltage 240 volt and 50 cycle of the electricity, even when the wind speed is fluctuating. Means that AC generator gives us a continuous supply of AC current even the wind speed is fluctuating. Okay. So DC generators are normally used in battery charging application and for operating DC appliances and machinery. So here basically they want to explain the difference between AC generator and DC generator. So as per our requirement, we have to choose what kind of generator we should need it. Okay. So you are using this for your electricity generation, and that electricity is directly used in your home applications or your official applications, then you should choose the AC generators. And if you are going to store that energy in batteries, then you should use DC generator. They also can be used to produce AC electricity with the use of an inverter, which can convert DC into AC. Means you can simply first you can store that energy in your battery in the DC form, and by using alternator or inverters, you can convert that DC into AC. Okay. Next, transmission. What is the function of transmission? See, the number of revolution per minute, that is RPM of wind turbine rotor, can range between 40 RPM to 400 RPM, depending on the model and the wind speed. So what is transmission? The blade that rotated having the speed or rotational speed of 40 RPM to 400 RPM only. But for the power requirement, we require 1200 to 1800. Okay, so this 1200 to 1800 RPMs of speed is required for the electricity generation in windmill. But the blades, if you see the windmills, the blades are rotating at 40 to 400 RPM. So how we are getting this much kind of RPM by using 40 RPM? How that 40 RPM should be converted into 1200 RPM? So this is happen with the help of your transmission system. Generally, this transmission system in which the gears converted this low speed RPM into high speed RPM with the help of gears. We can convert this into higher speed RPM and produce the electricity in windmill. Okay. As a result, most wind turbines require a gearbox transmission to increase the rotational of the generator to the speed necessary for efficient electricity generation. Means same the thing that I already discussed. So we must require a gearbox transmission system. So this gearbox transmission system is very helpful to improve your RPM. So here we are going to explain the function of each part. So don't need to just you have to read and remind those things. You are not going to copy or considering this thing or writing these things. You just understand what is the function of each and every part. So here, gearbox transmission is helps to increase your rotational speed for the efficient electricity generation. Some DC type wind turbines do not use transmission. In some cases, DC type turbines not use the transmission system because that turbine should not have economical or commercial application. So they want to minimize the cost of installation. So that's why they does not use the transmission system. They directly couple that rotating blade shaft to the generator. Okay. Instead, they have direct link between the rotor and generator. See, they have direct link between the rotor and generator. It does not require transmission system. These are known as direct drive system. So this kind of system is known as direct drive system. But in commercial application, this is not possible because we have to produce the uniform efficient electricity generation. Without a transmission, wind turbine complexity and maintenance requirements are reduced. Okay, so if we are not using transmission system, the complexity in the design and maintenance is reduced. So, but a much larger generator is required to deliver the same power output as the AC type wind turbine. But in that case, if we want to produce higher efficiency electricity, then we require a large generator or power output system. So this is the second way by which you can produce the electricity. Then function of tower. This component is also important. Why we are mounting that particular blades at particular height and what much height they should require. So here first we have to understand what is the function of power, then we should decide what is the height of that tower. Okay. So let's see. The tower on which a wind turbine is mounted is not just a support structure. It is not just a support structure. It also raises the wind turbine so that it stays safely clear the ground and so it can reach the stronger wind at higher elevation. Means there are three functions of wind tower. First, support the structure. Whatever structure we have made, that tower should help that structure. Second, it also raises the blade safety. Means the length of your blade should be low than that of the tower head. Otherwise, while rotating continuously, that blade should touch the earth surface. So in order to avoid this, the height of tower should be larger than that of the length of blade. Okay. And the third reason, we are getting higher or stronger wind at higher elevation. Okay. So the wind speed is higher at higher elevation. So this is the third main function of the tower. Okay. First is your support structure, second your blade safety, and third one is your higher wind elevations. Okay. Then next, maximum tower height is optional in most cases except where zoning restriction is applied. So you can choose the height, whatever the tower height as per your specification or as per your blade design, blade length or blade dimensions. The decision of what height tower to use will be based on your cost of taller tower versus the value of increase in energy production resulting from their use. So in the last lecture, when we see what is the economy of wind turbine, in that portion we are going to discuss this topic in detail. That is how to decide the height of a tower. So it is directly connected with your economy. That is the cost of installation. Whatever cost you are investing on the installation of that particular tower and what power you are getting from this particular windmill. So comparing both things, we should choose the proper or height of that tower. Okay. Next. Studies have shown that the added cost of increasing tower height is often justified by the added power generated from the stronger wind. Means wherever the regions where the height, as we increase the height, the wind speed increases, then in that case we should justify the higher height tower. Okay. So it is the real connection between your power generation and height. Okay. The last topic is your. Okay. The larger wind turbine height should ranges from the 40 to 70 meters tall. Means we can install 40 to 70 meter tall wind turbine. Tower for small wind systems are generally guide design. So in small tower system, guide designs are available. This means that there are guy wires anchored to the ground on three or four sides of the tower to hold it erect. Okay. So in small height, there are guide systems or that wire should be anchored with them. Okay. From three to four sides to hold that erect. This tower costs less than freestanding towers, but require more land area to anchor the guy wires. Okay. So in that case, if you are installing just a simple wind turbine, then this is possible. But you are going to n numbers of wind turbines series, then this kind of system is not possible because most of your area is required to anchor these guy wires. Some of these guy towers are erected by tilting them up. This operation can be quickly accomplished using only a winch with the turbine already mounted to the tower top. This simplifies Not only installation, but maintenance as well. Tower can be constructed of a simple tube, wooden pole, or lattice of tubes, rods, and iron. So you can use different materials to produce tower or construct a tower like wooden pole, lattice tubes, rods, and angle iron. A large wind turbine may be mounted on a lattice tower, tube towers, and guider towers. Okay, so this is about your tall stools. Okay, so I will. Okay, so all wind machines share certain operating characteristics such as cutting related and cutout wind speed. So what is cutting speed and cutout speed related speed? We will see here. Cutting speed is the maximum wind speed at which the blade will be turned and generate the usable power. So cutting speed is the maximum wind speed. Okay, maximum wind speed by which we can generate the power. This wind speed is typically between 10 to 16 km per hour. So maximum speed that is achieved, cutting speed is here 10 to 16 km per hour. What is rated speed? The rated speed is the maximum wind speed at which the wind turbine will generate the designated rated power. Means this is the usable generation, maximum wind speed for usable generate power and designated generate power. So what is the difference in usable power and designated power? Usable power means the speed by which we can just produce the usable power. But for that purpose, for what purpose we are going to design this wind? What is the rated or designated speed of that particular tower? The speed at which we are going to generate the electricity, that is designated rated power. So rated speed is designed for the designated rated power. Okay. For example, a 10 kilowatt wind turbine may not generate 10 kilowatt until wind speed reaches to the 40 kilometer per hour. Means if we are going to design a turbine, wind turbine for 10 kilowatt power production, then the rated speed is nearly about 40 kilometer per hour. Means for usable power, we are getting this speed 10 to 16 km per hour. We can produce the electricity, but if we have to produce this rated power, that is 10 kilowatt, we must reach this speed, that is 40 km per hour. Okay. So, rated speed for most machine is range of 40 to 55 km per hour. So this kind of rated speed we need, or this is the important factor for the production of electricity. At wind speed between cutting and rated, the power output from the wind turbine increases as the wind increases. Okay, as the wind increases, the power should be increased. It is the relation between power and wind speed. The output of most machine level of above the rated speed. Most manufacturers provide a graph called power curves showing how their wind turbine output varies with the wind speed. So these power curves are basically directly a graph. It's a graph between two axes. One axis represents your wind speed and one axis represents your power. So the directly graph between your wind speed and your power shows, known as your power curve. Okay. Then what is cutoff speed? Cutoff speed at very high wind speed, the typically between 72 kilometers to 128 kilometers per hour, most wind turbine cases power generation and shutdown. Is the power generation and shutdown. Means we require the higher wind speed for the power generation, but that should be within the limit. So cutting is the initial speed for the power generation. Rated is the maximum speed for the power generation, and cutoff the highest speed for the power generation. So for this speed, 72 km to 120 km per hour, if the speed is going to that much high, then automatically the power generation should be shut off. Okay. So there are three different speeds. One is cutting speed, rated speed, and cutout speed. Okay. The minimum speed, maximum minimum speed, rated speed, and maximum. Okay. The wind speed at which shutdown occurs called as the cutoff speed. Having a cutoff speed is safety features which protect the wind turbine from damage. So, this is a safety feature by which we can protect the damage of our wind turbine. Shutdown may be occur in one or several ways. In some mechanism, automatically shutdown, or some cases, spin sensor, speed sensors are utilized to shut down this particular mechanism. Okay, so this is all your cutting speed, rated speed, and cutoff speed. Okay, some machine is twist or pitch the blades to spill the wind. Still, other uses spoilers, drag flap mounted. So these are the safety devices that are going to use to stop the speed. And what is blades limit? It is the flow of air over the blade and through the rotor area that makes the wind turbine function. So what is the blades limit and what is its function? What is how wind power is produced? What is the formula power generation? That we will see in the next lecture. I will stop this lecture. Okay, so I will provide this PPT. So all of you should go through this PPT. And if any question, just ask me on the group. I will resolve your problem. Okay.